We finally got our hands on a 290X with a custom cooler. This makes me so happy that I could scream. Sapphire Tri-X R9 290X. It's got the fancy Tri-X cooling unit on it. It's three fans, and it's nice and long. They've extended this to add some more fins. We've got some fancy heat pipes going on down there, and all this is going to keep things very nice and cool. But at the same time, it's going to keep the noise levels down. So a lot of the problems people are having with the 290X are completely solved thanks to the triple or the Tri-X. I always want to say the triple X, but the Tri-X cooling unit from Sapphire. So first off, let's see what comes in the box. You get the graphics card, obviously. And we've got a driver CD in there. You can sling out the window because you're going to get the new ones that have Mantle and True Audio and all that fanciness and HSA. There's a couple power connectors, one that's an 8 to 4 pin power connector and then a 6 to 4 pin power connector. And also there's a 1.8 meter HDMI cable in the box. Now let's talk about the outputs on the card. We've got an HDMI, it's HDMI 1.4A, I believe, but that can support 4K at 30 hertz. And then we've got DisplayPort 1.2. And then we also have two DVI, and both of these are dual link DVI, so you can power all kinds of 1440p monitors if you like with this. The specs of the graphics card itself, it's overclocked to 1040 megahertz, and it's a 28 nanometer chip as well. You've got 2816 stream processors, 4 gigabytes of GDDR5, and that is clocked at 5200 megahertz effectively. The memory bit width is 512. The last thing I want to talk about before we get into some benchmarks and just some overall impressions of the card is the dimensions. This is a very long card. It's longer than the 780 Ti that I have, and it's also longer than the 7970 DirectCU2 from Asus that I have. That's a fatter card. This is only a dual slot card. They've made it dual slot by making it really long. So it's 305 millimeters long by 133 millimeters wide, and it's 38 millimeters high. And it also requires an 8-pin and a 6-pin power connector, and it can pull a lot of power from your system. They recommend at least a 750-watt power supply. I think you may be able to get by with a little bit less than that, depending on what you have in your system, but you do need a beefy power supply for this, because sometimes this can pull 300, 320, 330 watts if you're overclocking. Just by itself. And before I actually get into the benchmarks, I want to talk about noise and temperature levels because, you know, everyone already knows that the 290X benchmarks this way and it's, you know, it does pretty well in these games, et cetera, et cetera. But this is a special card, a special cooling unit. So I really wanted to come up with a good way to test the noise. And a lot of people, they do it on a test bench or they hold the, a decibel meter right up to the side of the card while it's on, and then they test it that way. And I want to test what you can hear with your ears while you're sitting at your computer, because that's what matters to me. So we put it in to Pistol's PC, and we're going to have some videos coming up soon showcasing her PC versus my PC. But we put it in there. She's got a Zigmatek Talon case, very normal case. It's not, sound dampened or anything like that, but it does a decent job. And then we set her phone on the table. This is half scientific with a decibel meter. We're using just, I think it's called sound meter or something like that. Now, just sitting on her desk, getting a reading of the ambiance here in this place. Let me get my coffee. The ambiance here. It's around 40 to 41 decibels, and that's only with her PC running, no AC, my computer's turned off, everything else is off, just her PC running. And then I let Valley run for about 15 to 20 minutes, somewhere in that range. I think it was actually around 17 minutes, and came back and did another reading, and it was at about 45 to 46 decibels. So there you go. This card can get very loud if you overclock it and ramp up the fans. But having three fans and having all the extra, surface area for dissipation and the heat pipes does a pretty damn good job. For instance, running it at 100%, it got up to about 80 to 81 Celsius, much better than the stock. And the fans were only running at 50 to 53%. And at 50 to 53%, it's at 45, 46 decibels. Now, I actually overclocked this thing to 1200 megahertz. And at 1200 megahertz, it was getting up to around 83 degrees Celsius, and the fan kicked up to 60. And you definitely could hear, it's a little bit louder, a few more decibels. And if you crank this thing all the way up to 100%, it's very loud. But I don't think you'll ever need to crank it higher than about 60% as far as the fan speed goes. So I just left it on auto. I mean, it obviously knows how much fan speed it needs to stay cool, and I usually prefer to leave it on auto unless you have some extreme circumstances where you need to go in and tune it. But you can use their Trick software to go in and completely tune it, overclock it. I did not see much of an improvement as far as the FPS goes with the overclock to 1200 megahertz. So, I mean, we're talking like 0.1 frame per second or 0.2 frames per second. So I'm not sure what's going on there. I'll update my drivers and try it again. So in this video, we're only going to benchmark with the overclock from Sapphire, which is, you know, 1040 megahertz. So let's start off with my ridiculously crazy modded version of Skyrim. This is not going to be indicative of your Skyrim's performance because mine is quite different, but I'll be able to compare this to my 780 Ti in a very soon upcoming video. My version of Skyrim, 2400 by 1200, we're averaging 34.36 frames per second. I'm running a million texture packs, and they really actually like the extra memory that this one has, the 4 gigabytes of GDDR5. All right, let's take a look at Trine 2. Trine 2 can actually be very taxing if you turn the filters all the way up to max, like we did here. 1080p, everything maxed out completely. The average was 97.28. At 1440p, with everything completely maxed out, the average was 53.2. And the min and the max were 49 and 57, so it's a very, you know, very, very playable and smooth game. BioShock Infinite. I turn everything to max. I know some people online benchmark without anti-aliasing and that sort of thing, but I just turn everything onto max because this is a 290X after all. The average at 1080p was 73.2. It never dropped below 46. And then at 1440p, the average was 56, but it never dropped again below 46. So the same minimum there. Pretty good frame pacing, in my opinion. If you guys want to know like the actual frame times on this, I'll throw a zip file on the website that has you know, all that data. It's from Fraps, so it's not as scientific as you know, like FCAT or something like that, but it completely does the job for most of us out there, unless you want to get uber nerdy, and then there's plenty of resources online that you can check out. All right, Crysis 3. I'm going to throw the settings on the screen so you guys can see exactly how we're running this. And we benchmark this at a very taxing part of the game, right in the beginning, when you're following Psycho into the facility and it's raining like crazy. That's where we benchmark because there's a lot of stuff going on. So with, I guess, everything turned up 1080p, the average was 42.4 frames per second. And once you get into the building, it becomes extremely playable, but it never dropped below 37 FPS. At 1440p, the average was 27.24 frames per second, and it dropped down all the way to 24 frames per second. But again, at 1440p, once you get out of that really taxing area and into the building, it actually is very playable. I just like to benchmark it there because that's the worst case scenario. And that's what I like. I like worst case scenarios, man. A lot of people online were like, hey, your Crysis 3 benchmarks, my computer's way faster. I'm like, you're probably benchmarking in a different section of the game, or you're probably using slightly different settings. All right, Unigine Valley. Let's talk about that. It's a very, very pretty benchmark. And we use that for a lot of our stress tests and temperature test readings. All right, so benchmarking at 1080p, the average was 60.1 frames per second with a score of 2516. And then benchmarking again at 1440p, the average was 38.1 frames per second. And we just put this on like the complete ultra settings, but you guys can see all that. We threw it on the screen. Next up, Metro Last Light. I benchmarked it at 1080p only, but I did it at completely the max settings. Had to turn off PhysX because you turn that on with an AMD card and it just coughs and explodes. 1080p, everything maxed. We got 45.04 frames per second. And it did at one point drop down to 16.81 frames per second. So a little bit up and down, but the max was 73.54. And that's with the CAN Metro Last Light benchmark. All right, last up, I wanted to do some OpenCL benchmarking. So we just grabbed a copy of LuxMark. You guys can grab a copy of that. It's a free software that, you know, you can download and benchmark your OpenCL performance potentiality. Anyway, so the LuxMark score with just the 290X is 3196. Pretty damn good. These are also going like crazy for Bitcoin mining. As far as the price to performance ratio, this is a very good card. For Bitcoin mining, I'm not sure if I wouldn't just go ahead and find a used 7970 online or something like that. Those could be pretty good for Bitcoin mining as far as the price to performance, but for gaming, this is really, really a good way to go. And you know, we haven't really done any Mantle tests yet. I want to make a separate Mantle video, and there's like a canned benchmark out there, And then there's Battlefield 4, but I don't have a copy of that right now. So no Mantle benchmarks. There's also not a lot of gains between DirectX and Mantle with uber, you know, performant cards like the 290X. So no Mantle tests until we get more Mantle stuff. But I also love the fact that this supports True Audio. I had an experience with True Audio at CES, and it's probably the coolest audio experience I've had during a gaming session ever. It was freaking amazing. So that's another, you know, technology that you're going to get with the 290X. Mantle and True Audio, very, very cool. Also FreeSync, but that's something we're not going to really talk about in this video. So that's just some benchmarks, initial impressions. Very high quality card. I really like the cooling unit. No real complaints. I mean, other than the fact that there's a bunch of vendors online price gouging. Not vendors, it's a bunch of online e-tailers that are price gouging these things like crazy, so they need to stop that so these can be a little bit easier to get. But I mean, I think it's a hell of a card. So what we're going to do next, we've got a few battles coming up. I'm going to put this head-to-head with the GTX 780 and the 780 Ti in a future video. If you guys want to get an idea about that, I'll be doing some re-benchmarks with some different games and that sort of thing, but you guys can go back and watch the 780 and the 780 Ti overview videos and get some ideas as how it performs compared to those. And then I'm going to test it again in Pistol System. She's got a 9590 from AMD, one of the FX processors, and I've got a 4930K. Now this, by the way, this is all tested in my machine, and you guys can check out the video on my machine by clicking on the screen right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to test my machine versus hers. Mine's more expensive. I've got the 4930K and a GTX 780 Ti. She's got the 9590, and she probably could have gotten by with an 8350, and a lot of you guys should just probably grab one of those, but you know, we could, so we did get the 9590, and then she's got the 290X in there. Other than that, they're very similar systems, very similar systems. So we're gonna put those head to head and you know, have a little battle, see what happens. Other than that, if you guys appreciate the videos, there's links on the side, tech support and all that kind of stuff. Just click on things, man, and we'll see you next time.
This is for sex appeal.
Go.